Hi, my name is Annie Guadagnin, and I'm a PhD student under Dr. Phil Cardoso here at the University of Illinois. And one of the main research areas that we focus on at the Dairy Focus Lab is the impact of nutrition on reproduction and health of dairy cows. There is a link between inflammation and infertility, between immunity and infertility. And that is what we're going to discuss a little bit more about today.
It is known that 80 to 90% of dairy cows will have their reproductive tract contaminated with bacteria after calving. So basically almost all of the cows are susceptible to uterine infections. Then a strong immune response is needed to clear these pathogens and also to help with the uterus involution and regeneration to prep for the next gestation. To explain with more details about this inflammation process and its connection with infertility, I have here the schematic that was adapted from a review paper from Sheldon and others published in 2009. I will provide this reference in the comments as well. So first, here we have the uterine epithelium, which is already a defense mechanism as it forms a barrier to stop the entry of pathogens. Here we can see an example of a TLR4-MD2-CD14 complex, which recognizes pathogen-associated molecular patterns, but it can also recognize other molecules, such as NIFA, for example. So here's the stroma, some blood vessels, and here on the left corner, we have the representation of an ovary with a follicular wave developing, following to ovulation and development of a corpus luteum. At the top, we have the pituitary, which by the release of GnRH from the hypothalamus, it will release FSH, which is the follicular stimulant hormone, and LH, the luteinizing hormone, and both of them will act in the ovaries. But when there is an infection in the uterus, the innate immune response is alerted by the toll-like receptor, which detects the bacterial DNA in lipids, or LPS, such as this one here. Upon detection of the pathogen-associated molecular patterns by this transmembrane complex, the endometrial cells will secrete chemokines such as interleukin-8 and cytokines such as interleukin-1 beta, for example, but also antimicrobial peptides to fight these foreign molecules. The cytokines and the chemokines will direct the immune response, attracting polymorphonuclear cells such as neutrophils and also macrophages to eliminate the bacteria. However, the neutrophil function is perturbed in high-producing dairy cows, particularly when they are facing negative energy balance. And the persistence of neutrophils in the endometrium without the presence of pathogens can characterize subclinical endometritis. The endometrial damage and inflammation reduce the chance of conception. So here we have our first problem. Another effect is regarding the hormone releasing. So the FSH concentrations are not affected by uterine disease, so the follicular waves emerge without any problem in the first weeks after calving. However, because the release of GnRH and LH can be suppressed by LPS, the ability of that dominant follicle to ovulate is reduced. Also, it was already found that the follicular fluid of animals with endometritis can also contain LPS. And since the granulosa cells express the TLR4, MD2, CD14 complex required to detect these molecules, it will result in a reduction in aromatase expression, reducing estradiol secretion. And that is why we see cows with endometritis having slower growth of dominant follicles in the ovary and lower peripheral plasma estradiol concentrations, being less likely to ovulate. Also, the fact that bacteria can switch the endometrial epithelial secretion of prostaglandins from the F to the E series, as shown here, can also cause a disruption in the luteolysis. But okay, we know that some of the cows with endometritis can still ovulate and they can still form a corpus luteum. However, the peripheral plasma concentrations of progesterone are going to be lower than normal fertile animals, and the luteal phases are going to be extended.
Okay, so we saw that the endometrial cells have a key role in the innate immune response, and this leads to a modulation in the endocrine function, linking the immunity with infertility. And if you're interested and want to know a little bit more about this topic, Our group has been doing research in this area for the past few years, and we have a lot more information on our website. Also, we have there a list of the papers that we have been publishing aborting this topic. You can also get in contact with us through our Facebook page. We also have an Instagram account, or you can just email us and we'll be happy to talk about. Thank you.